watching the longest running episodic television show in history. Welcome to Monday Night Raw.
What a night we've got planned for you. I don't know what it is, gentlemen, but something feels different tonight. Bigger than usual.
Despite what Byron Saxton said about him in the past, Shelton Benjamin is a true legend, and he's ready for action.
The gold standard in WWE.
Making his way to the ring from Orangeburg, South Carolina, weighing in at 248 pounds, Shelton Benjamin.
Shelton Benjamin once upon a time held the United States Championship for 240 days. Incredible.
And don't let your past with Shelton Benjamin cloud your judgment, Byron. He is an absolutely incredible athlete, professional wrestler here in sports entertainment, the gold standard.
Shelton's one of these athletes that makes everything he does look almost effortless.
Guys, what better way to start the night off than with this one?
I can't think of a better match to kick the night off, Michael. In fact, we haven't even gotten started yet, and I can assure you that this will be a tough match to follow.
You can feel the electricity running through this arena. This is going to be some battle, one-on-one, mano-a-mano.
An amateur wrestling standout with almost two decades of in-ring experience. It's going to be tough to stop Shelton Benjamin.
And no matter what color his hair is that day, Shelton Benjamin truly is the gold standard.
Nailed it. Punch right to the face. A running senton.
Crushing impact.
His shoulders are down. Yeah, I don't believe that he didn't win this match right there.
Not yet.
Boom, right to the face.
He's starting to show signs of fatigue. With these two guys, we all knew this was going to be an all-out battle. I think a lot of people right now are scratching their heads wondering how he let this match get so out of hand.
Oh, man.
But, oh, beautiful technique.
One's over. Uh-oh!
Sizing him up.
In trouble!
Doesn't even see it.
Oh, what a boot.
Can't waste any time here.
What impact.
Ah, backdrop suplex. Escapes trouble there.
Cutter! He's not going to like this.
Bitter's going right in the button.
But he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
One, two, three. Cassius Ohno with the victory!
Congratulations, Cassius.
Here is your winner, Cassius Ohno.
And that's the win to start off the night.
And if that match is any indication of what to expect here tonight, we are in for an amazing evening.
Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.
He's teetering on.
Oh, man, rolling elbow. This one's over, guys.
Making his way to the ring, from Melbourne, Australia, weighing in at 203 pounds, Buddy Murphy.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for one-on-one action.
And Michael, it sounds to me like this crowd already picked the one who they want to win this match.
His opponent, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 193 pounds, Drew Gulak.
Guys, we're getting the night started with an amazing matchup here.
You're absolutely right, Cole. In fact, I don't think there's a better way to start this night than with this match right here.
Drew Gulak will be doing all he can to keep his ring a no-fly zone.
And this is one of those matches where it's hard to believe we get paid for this. Well, actually,
It's hard to believe Saxton gets paid for anything.
Boom! What a drop kick.
On the mark.
Boom! Right across the small of the back. It'll destroy your face.
Look at that tremendous ring presence.
Very impressive.
Penny predicament. And a kick out. Not even close on that one.
Just not enough damage done yet, Cole.
Harsh impact.
What a stomp. Good grief.
Oh, man.
Oh, this is dangerous right here. He misses the dive.
And unfortunately for him, there was no water in the pool.
Oh, nasty impact. What a stomp. Good grief. Oh, man. What a stomp. Good grief. Boom. Oof.
Hits the mark.
He's on the defensive here.
Well, he knew this was going to be a fight heading into this one.
Wow, let's not get ahead of ourselves, Cole. This is just a little bump in the road for him here. Nothing to worry about.
This is all part of the process, guys. He knew he would take on some offense here tonight. Oh. He just has to make sure he keeps it to a minimum.
Powerbomb planted. I got right to the gut.
Take.
With all the damage done, you have to wonder how much more it'll take.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
Hurricane Rana!
I believe we're in for some more of Gulak's ramblings tonight for how he's got a plan for a better 205 Live. I mean, I hope not, but I think it's gonna happen.
Stops the count on the ropes.
Oh, my goodness. There's the...
Byron mentioned Gulak's plan for a better 205 Live, whether it's been picket signs or slideshow presentations on the Titantron. Gulak has been insistent on molding 205 Live into his twisted vision.
Well, I think Gulak has some great ideas. All I hear you two do is criticize it. If you two have any better ideas on how to make 205 Live better, why don't you guys go make a slideshow?
What a strike.
If he sticks this, he is done.
It's in, it's in!
Night, night.
That's what he was looking for, Michael.
No, he releases the holds.
What in the world is he thinking? Does he not want to win?
For years, Monday night has been the most...
He goes for the cover.
One. There's the kick out.
He isn't going to go away that easy.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Nailed it. You got to believe this one.
it's over. This one's getting ugly. You might want to turn away if you have a weak heart. Oh, what impact!
Oh, that's gonna hurt.
Great job escaping, trying to turn this thing around.
Drew Gulak, big move coming.
This one is over. The shoulders are down.
Oh, he kicked out. Unbelievable.
Too soon.
We pull. Clothesline.
Got it. Beautiful technique.
I knew. Oh.
I think this is the beginning of the end, Michael.
Whoa, I didn't see that coming.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Oh, knee strike.
That's how you put an exclamation point on the end of a mat.
He's got the shoulders down. And you could put this singles match in the books.
Here is your winner, Drew Gulak.
Kicking off the night with an impressive victory.
If that's the type of action we're going to get all night long, I can't wait to see the rest of the card unfold.
What a way to kick off tonight. Don't go anywhere, folks. We're just getting started.
Woman in the entire women's division?
You are delusional. Mella is money.
Oh, it's great where you can wear blinders.
Why would I want blinders on when Mella's around?
So what would you know anything about how to win a title like Mella?
So I see you're kissing up to Carmella as well.
Why wouldn't I? I think she's an unbelievable talent.
Mella is money.
Guys, we have two of WWE's most exciting superstars ready to square off here.
And there's nothing quite like seeing two superstars settling it in the ring in one-on-one action, Michael.
It's known that Becky Lynch has had friction with Carmella since their days in NXT. But when Carmella robbed Becky of becoming the first Miss Money in the Bank, that brought the tension between the two to a boiling point.
Well, can you blame Becky, Michael? She had the Money in the Bank contract won until Carmella drilled her with a chair from behind. That put the Staten Island Princess directly in Becky's sights.
And with the women's division as white hot as it is right now, you just know this match is going to be one for the ages.
How about that Becky Lynch-Carmella rivalry, gentlemen? I find your observations horribly biased. Talk about revisionist history. The Princess of Staten Island did what any other woman in that match would have done. If Becky can't accept that, it's just too bad.
Becky was inches away from the briefcase, Corey, until the blatant interference from that lackey, James Ellsworth. It was total injustice.
Boom, what impact. What a clothesline.
Ouch.
This might be it.
Oh, my.
Harsh impact. Oh, nasty impact.
Important to Becky Lynch after she made history as the first ever SmackDown Live Women's Champion was to establish herself as a fighting champion.
You got that right, Michael. The Irish Last Kicker accepted all challenges that came her way.
Carmella makes a cover.
Up and down. What a slam.
Easily kicks out of that one.
She came here to fight, not lay down.
Oh, man.
Right to the arm. Hyper extends her elbow.
Oh, straight forearm.
To expand on Byron's point about Becky Lynch's mentality as the inaugural SmackDown Live Women's Champion, just take a look at the superstars who Lynch defeated to retain the title.
Yeah, whether it's deserved or not, first champions are always
set. Ring rattling!
She got all of it there.
Going to have a hard time stopping Becky when she's doing this.
Ah, drop kick to the spine. You gotta believe this one's over.
Uh-oh.
I'm afraid to think what's going to happen next.
Got her where she wants her.
Big time move coming up.
Impactful slam.
Becky Lynch is looking for the ending.
She doesn't want to get up.
Pump handle,
up and oh, what impact.
That should do it.
Becky Lynch makes the cover.
Two.
I wouldn't have been surprised if that was it.
Wow. This is amazing. Don't know if it's going to work, but Becky is playing mind games now.
She dodges that one.
Drop kick hits the mark.
Drop kick.
Oh, great height.
A maneuver like that is a great way to turn the tables.
Look at this.
The missile drop kick finds its mark.
What a forearm.
All measured up.
She is on fire.
Carmella is more dangerous than ever. The Princess of Staten Island is filled with a hostility we've never seen before, so if a superstar is going to go up against her, they have to strike early.
Oh, man, she's rolling now.
Missile drop kick finds its mark.
Once again, thank you for tuning into this great women's
Exploder.
It does not look good for Carmella here.
They got him.
Got the arm.
Got the disarmer.
It does not look good for Carmella here.
All that's left now is for Becky Lynch to finish.
Corey, before you mention that, Carmella is more aggressive than ever. Now, she's got a tremendous amount of resilience, so I think she's got something left here.
Wow, Carmella somehow digs deep and finds a way to keep fighting. She's a beast.
Going to the top, high risk. Incoming.
Oh, man, what a leg drop.
Looks like she wants to win early.
Two, three.
There's the pin. It's over. It's all over.
Here is your winner, Becky Lynch.
And the first match of the night comes to an end in thrilling fashion.
Yeah, the performance put forth in that match tells me we're looking at somebody who will someday, very soon, be competing in the main event.
What a match that was, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for joining us.
Welcome to the Uso Penitentiary.
On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 479 pounds, Jimmy Uso and Jay.
One of the great tag teams of all time. Jimmy and Jay have been on a run recently that has redefined the tag team division in WWE. No question about it.
Dude, dudes genuinely entertained me more than just about anybody.
And their opponent, at a combined weight of 492 pounds, the NXT Tag Team Champions, Montez Ford and Angelo Dawkins.
Hey, Corey, let me see your
swag.
Byron, I didn't think it was possible, but you saying what you just did somehow make Dawkins and Ford less cool.
Can you imagine all three of us walking into a club, cutting a rug or two?
I can. Byron, you're humiliating yourself.
Look, I am in with the Street Profits. Angelo Dawkins.
You're not, Byron. You're making them less money right now. The Street Profits want nothing to do with you. These two dudes are legit. They're incredibly talented. They're tough. And they know how to have a good time that doesn't involve a bicycle museum.
I even feel like dancing.
Montez Ford is one of the best dressed guys in all of sports entertainment. And coming from me, that means something.
The son of WWE Hall of Famer Rikishi and husband of Naomi, WWE is betting forever will be a fixture in Jimmy Uso's life.
Settle in, guys. This is going to be a blast to watch.
Beautiful technique.
This might be it.
Oh, my.
Tag team history was made when the first ever SmackDown Tag Team Champions were crowned at Backlash 2016. The unlikely duo of Rhino and Heath Slater caught lightning in a bottle and ran through the tag team title tournament. In the finals, Rhino and Slater took on the Usos to see which team would be the inaugural Tag Team Champions.
Ooh, what impact.
Elbow drop!
Incredible power.
Wow, what a vertical suplex.
There was a lot on the line in the tag team tournament finals. The Usos wanted to add another tag team title reign to their resume and enjoyed the recognition of being the first ever SmackDown Tag Team Champions. The team of Rhino and Heath Slater was the team no one expected to be in the finals. Slater had extra motivation because he was fighting for a WWE contract.
And at one point, it seemed like the Usos had everything well in hand, but Rhino and Heath Slater refused to lose.
After a gore from Rhino practically cut Jimmy Uso in half, Rhino and Heath Slater went from an unlikely tag team to the first ever SmackDown Tag Team Champions. Never say never in WWE is absolutely right.
What a stomp! Good grief!
Right to the... Here's a cover.
Boom!
He got body on body there, but that's about it.
And the match continues.
Oh, nasty impact.
Nailed it.
What grace. Float over into the... Oh, what a DDT.
Wow.
Oof.
Now it's Jey Uso on the defensive.
Ouch.
We all know, though, this guy has plenty of fight left in him.
It might be time for him to recharge that battery. All he has to do is get to his corner and make the tag.
In a tag team contest, a superstar and partner lock up against another duo. Unless there's a special stipulation added to the match, the traditional rules of a singles match apply in terms of winning the match via pinfall, submission, countout, or disqualification.
Harsh impact. You gotta believe this one's over. This might be it.
Oh, my.
In a standard tag team match, one competitor is in the ring against an opponent, and their teammate is in their corner standing on the ring apron. I should also point out that the competitor in the ring, as far as the referee is concerned, is the legal man. Only the legal man can attempt to score a ball over an opponent who will be defeated.
Arm is grapevine. Try to step through. Uh-oh. Here it comes.
Tequila Sunrise.
Saxton, you should eat the worm.
He's in control now.
He's struggling a bit here. He came into this match looking for a fight, and it looks like he found one.
Oh, and he breaks free.
But the damage might have already been done, Michael.
And what a reversal from Jey Uso.
Wow, I thought he was a goner.
Ooh! Oh, this is the best. A couple of jabs.
A little shake, rattle, and roll.
Oh, man!
Jey Uso beginning to look a little uneasy.
This tag team match is dangerously close to getting out of control for him.
Why he's still in the match at this point is beyond me, guys. Maybe he forgot it's a tag team match.
Man.
I don't know. There's got to be some explanation.
But if you're counting him out now, you haven't been paying attention. He has more resolve than just about anybody on the roster.
What a stomp! Good grief!
Ooh, right in the face!
Destroyed! Ooh, nasty impact.
Elbow!
We've got a cover.
Boom!
Nice!
And he kicks out.
Remarkable.
Oof!
And he dropped the cover. It's going to take more than that to keep his shoulders down.
How in the world?
And set him up.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Vertical suplex.
Nice. Now we see Jimmy Uso.
Batista, what a spear from the Animal.
And that will likely end Jay's night.
Boom, what impact.
Angelo Dawkins is getting ready.
And that...
to start the show.
I knew these two were a great team. I just didn't know how great. Wow, they really impressed me out here.
Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks. Stay tuned for more great action.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. And it's for the WWE Universal Heavyweight Championship.
What a great match we have here to start off this night, guys.
And Michael, I had to check twice when I saw this match listed as our opener. I mean, it could very well have been our main event.
Him.
And he's awake now. He's woken, Cole. Distinctly different. Explain that to me, Corey.
One that cannot truly understand woken wisdom can never adequately understand it.
What kind of riddle is that?
Woken.
Sounds like gibberish.
What's it like being in the ring with this man? Psychologically baffling. Every time you think you figured out what Bray Wyatt's gonna do, he does the polar opposite.
That's just the way Bray Wyatt likes it.
Look at how many fireflies there are.
It's amazing.
These people actually believe in this guy.
Absolutely amazing.
Introducing the challenger from Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth Rollins. Introducing the champion, weighing in at 285 pounds, he is the WWE Universal Heavyweight Champion, Bray Wyatt.
Definitely an electric feeling in this venue tonight.
Man, this card is just packed with so many great matches, and this one is definitely among the most anticipated, I'd say.
Bray is making the hairline back stand up.
That's disgusting. The atmosphere out here is chilly, it's creepy, it's unsettling, and that's exactly the way Bray Wyatt wants it.
Moonsault!
Too much offense up to this point, but that can obviously all change here.
Wyatt kicking some serious tail here.
Running crossbody.
Nicely done.
Now look at his aggression, just pure brutality.
Come on, easy.
Fake first right into the buckle. Seth Rollins going for the cover.
Architect trying to end this thing early.
And a kick out by Bray Wyatt.
Not yet.
We've seen champions head into matches maybe a little too comfortable.
Bray Wyatt drives his opponent down with a uranage. Can he finish the job? Now, Bray Wyatt needs to capitalize on this opportunity.
Boy, does he ever.
That's using your head.
Harsh impact.
Speaking of champions heading into matches a bit overconfident, one of the most glaring examples of that would have to be the Honky Tonk Man's attitude heading into his Intercontinental Championship defense at SummerSlam 1988. We all know what happened to him on that night.
You are so right, Mike. That was great, of course, though. It wasn't so great for the Honky Tonk Man, who ended up losing his championship to the Ultimate Warrior in fewer than 30 seconds.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy. This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Oh,
you have to like his chances here.
Oh, no, Seth Rollins needs to worry now.
Yeah, the clock's ticking on the Kingslayer.
What a Sister Abigail.
That has got to be it.
Oh,
man, what a shining wizard.
Oh, my goodness, this hurts. Oh!
Bray Wyatt may get this, folks.
Nailed it.
Rollins fans have plenty to worry about here.
Got the shoulders down. Oh, how resilient was that?
I can't believe what we're seeing here.
This Bray Wyatt really creeps me out.
Well, the Architect is rolling now. Slam down hard.
No, there's the reversal.
Running cross body.
Nicely done.
Oh, and he reverses it. Float over.
Oh. And it was DDT.
Spiked him.
Somebody wound him up, and he's off and running.
We know what's coming here.
Frog splash.
Seth freaking Rollins. Unbelievable.
Here's the pin. Title on the line.
It's going to take a lot more than that to keep him down.
Too early in the match to end it.
Seth Rollins is going up.
Opponent down with a uranage.
Rollins fans have plenty to worry about here.
You gotta believe this one's over.
That should do it.
Oh no, Seth Rollins,
shoulders on the mat.
One, two.
What is keeping this competitor going?
How'd he do that?
definitely not where you want to be right now.
Gotta find a way to get out of this, Michael.
Bray Wyatt, big move coming.
Boom, nice.
What a stomp.
Good grief.
And here we go. Seth Rollins sees his opening.
What a comeback.
Things don't look good for Bray Wyatt.
Moving into the cover with the title on the line.
New champion. New champion.
And he got a near fall out of it.
Too soon.
Seth Rollins has him right where he wants him.
It might be cliche, but it's true here. It ain't over till it's over.
He's definitely tapped a power source.
Short arm clothesline. Drop down. Here we go.
Wow, I'm just as surprised as you guys are.
The end is near for him.
Ooh,
to think I almost wrote him off earlier.
Quickly into the cover with the title on the line.
The champion.
And with that, Bray Wyatt continues his reign.
Victory.
And you just know the rest of the card is watching in the back, wondering how in the world they're going to follow that.
Plenty more action still to come here tonight, folks.